great shot of both of you.
That's good. Glad to help out.
When I come back in for the next time we try this, I'd like to make sure I have a mic on you also, Lena, if I can catch you next time here.
You're more than happy to do so.
Bah, humbug.
Bah, humbug.
What do you think that, Charlie, what do you think that experiences do you think drag queens have in performing that would be helpful for all performers to know, or essential things that you can learn from being a drag queen?
Well, not just being a drag queen, but in performing you learn to deal with the public more so, and it, when you leave this, if you do, you go into public work, you'll know how to handle every situation, how to kiss the right ass, I guess. No, just how to deal with the public in general. Because you got to know this.
What's strong
point? One thing I've always preached to my entertainers is the day you think you're a star, you'll never be one. Mm-hmm. A star attitude gets you nothing but attitude from everybody around you and people that look at what she thinks she's a star, you know. And the day you quit learning, it's the day you're not an entertainer.
Every day you learn.
I learned different little things about makeup. I'll do something one night and go, wow, why? And I've been doing this in the past 30 years. I've been doing it the same way, you know. But this just little. And I have learned so much from watching young entertainers do their makeup.
Mm-hmm. Never too old to learn.
Watching a baby drag queen do her makeup, I'll go, I'm so stupid, why didn't I do that? Or I love what that, the effect that pulls, you know. But if you quit learning, you don't need to be in the business.
That's true.
And
that's
if you're not true. Nervous, when you walk on that stage, you're not an entertainer. When you think you've got it all and know it all, you don't know shit. But you must act like you do. It does help, don't it, Lena?
Yeah.
Now this is the polish ups right here. See her coming out.
Do you think Bill Clinton or Bush would look better in drag?
I don't know, but if you watched It's My Bush Yet.
No, what is that?
Comedy Central. It's a total comedy takeoff of George Bush in the White House. It is the funniest thing I have seen in years, and the writers of South Park have produced it.
Oh, my God.
And so you can imagine. But it's the funniest sitcom I've seen in years. Comes on Wednesday nights, 10 o'clock. Ma'am, 10:30, can I push that? Sure. Comedy Central, laugh along with me. Mm-hmm.
do you keep your material fresh? That's it.
I watch the news, the playoffs, the news. Constantly trying to come up anew. Every comedian has got their base. You watch any comedian on Comedy Channel, anytime you see the comedian, he's got his base that he works with. And then he varies out of it into today's situations and things like that. I love to play out. I watch the news. I love to play out the news.
Performing in Atlanta compared to other cities.
If you do it here, you do it anywhere.
Yes.
Atlanta's one of the most critical cities there is. It's the hardest city in the country to work.
Is it because all the queens are so...
It's because it's been exposed to drag for so many years. It's always been like the headline city of drag.
What were some of the best drag bars here in Atlanta over the years?
Every one of them has always had its own specialty. Sweet Gum Head, The Locker Room,
Onyx,
Illusions,
Lipstick,
Jim Nally's,
Stutz, Levitas,
Lipsticks,
Numbers.
They've all had different character of entertainers and different styles, and each one has helped develop Atlanta to where it is. That's what I've always said about every bar in Atlanta. Every bar has got its own character, and it's got its own major following.
Hollywood Heights was the first bar I went to, Mike.
Do you get recognized out of costume?
Yeah. I work out at Gold's Gym in Austell, and this girl tapped me on, I was on the treadmill, just getting it, honey, and this little girl tapped me on the shoulder and said, "I just live for your show." I think I've seen her back in there.
Hey!
Hey, honey. This is Joey with Out TV, Pauline.
Nice to meet you. Is he filming you?
Uh-huh. You got something you want me to write it on?
No. I'm going to graduate. You'll have all the time in the world. How's that?
So I look at it and snap.
Oh, yeah.
Is that your house?
Uh-huh.
Go, Marie. Thank you very much.
Have a good night, hon.
You too. I'll see y'all tomorrow.
Okay.
You want this open or closed, Charlie?
It don't matter, hon. Oh, that lovely sound. So you're mainly just going to do me and Lena tonight?
Real TV action. Yeah, I think so. If I spread out too much, I won't be able to. I think I'll get a good, solid base from tonight as far as a story.
Right.
Telling a story. that we can do with this footage. Lena, I'd like to have your input on it too. This is definitely your material, so I wanted to be able to provide you with the digital copies of this. And Charlie, if you could mention that to Mike, that you want that as part of your... I think you need to have a copy for yourself.
Yeah.
So we're giving you something.
I think that's a good idea.
Mike is real sweet about, real generous about doing that. We all want to profit, you know, get something from it.
Right.
Of course, if HBO picks this up, somebody, we won't profit more.
Oh, you are worth a kid now.
Is that
who you're doing first?
No, probably. I'm about to go on the bikes right now. But I probably lost that. I lost the rest of mine.
Lena, I'll probably do my setups the way I did it last night.
Oh, okay.
So when you sign up, you'll know.
Was hard on me, of course, and I was like 7 years old, so I didn't take much, and her pumps, I tried her pumps on, I get both my feet in one of her pumps, but yeah, that was the first time, but I had no idea that I'd be doing this for a living. So my mother was a seamstress too, so she made a lot of clothes for other people as well. Never made me anything as far as doing drag clothes, but she made a lot of my brother's clothes when we were growing up. I have two brothers and a sister. I'm the oldest daughter, I tell everybody.
Oh, I've already got planned. We're gonna do, I want you to do the lipstick, and because that's what pulls everything together.
The lipstick, I know. Once you put the lips on, that's it. Haven't arrived.
A young entertainer?
Get
you a good job because it's expensive to get a foot in the door these days. You have to have a national title or a major city title, which costs a lot of money, costume and dancers and choreographers.
Where does your promotion come from, within a bar, or do you have
based in starting out, you're going to promote yourself. Because crowds want it polished. Life's a bitch, and so am I.
Julia Roberts lives. Now to juice them up. Cheers, Atlanta. I'm having to replace the lash. So let me.
Does the two master ask you to put your weight back on again?
No.
Okay, because I think that I pushed the wrong fucking button during that.
Oh no, you erased me! Old Queen, gotta have the big magnifier. Lena, yours is in Braille, ain't it? I had to get that in there. Are you ready, Atlanta? It's showtime at Backstreet in Charlie Brown's Cabaret. Life's a bitch, so am I.
be Atlanta right now.
Absolutely.
Doing a story on Charlie Brown.
Charlie Brown.
Charlie Brown.
It's Charlie Brown. Well, I'm Fifi, and I do the kitchen, and this is Gino. Yeah. He does the hot dogs.
What do you guys have? Do you have a lot of business here during her show?
We have a lot of good business. They're hungry all the time. I feed her, too.
Right. I hear she drinks a lot of coffee.
She drinks a lot of coffee. She brings her coffee pot to me. She brings her coffee pot, and I clean the lipstick off the cup.
Cool.
It's Charlie Brown.
It's Charlie Brown.
Thanks. It's Charlie Brown.
Have a good night.
Straighten out to the Shoney Super Bowl bangs of your life. down there, what the fuck were you thinking when you got your bangs where they wet? When you said, I'm gonna trim my bangs, honey. They were wet, honey. When that motherfucker dried, they went, meow. Never cut your fucking hair with a soup bowl, honey, while your hair is wet. Girl, you think that trick plastic? Girl, representing Frederick here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. Please let your hand.
Mo made that hairstyle popular back in the 50s.
Fish! Fish! Swim to your seat.
Everybody wants them. I know how to get a fish. Gentlemen representing Gap. We have Walmart here, Target here. Come, fish, we will squeeze you. No, you can't sit in the chair, honey. You know it. Is this your motherfucking club, bitch? Is this your fucking club? No, it ain't. You fuck with me, bitch, and I'll have a lesbian eat your ass out. You ain't seen Charming, I can hold you your ugly ass. Look, half of them are sitting here. Honey, I have got more makeup on than all 15 of these bitches put together. That's true. And hey, guess what? I make more money acting like a woman than all 15 of you bitches put together. Girl, Emma.
You in a gay club looking at a man prettier than you.
No way. Nah, look, bitch, that skirt cut up that high on your dress. On your ugly little legs, you're going,
she let you girls sit down, and the less you say back is the best.
Oh,
okay, I'll take that.
Yeah. So, you don't want to fuck for me, okay? Look. Every one of them has got a dildo on the end of their straw. So where is the fraternity from? I figured she was getting married. Where are y'all from?
All over.
All over. Girl, we've got every trailer park in Georgia. Truly, look at her. Are you gay? Well, out of all of them, I would have picked you because you got the butch's haircut. And then the one getting married. Oh, no.
It's not the hair up here that counts.
It's not the hair up there that counts. It's the tongue, right, hon? And where are you from?
Texas.
Oh, no wonder. She's a bush plum coming up in here in Georgia trying to get nasty with a head drag queen. Girl, see, you need to be friendly with me. I can dress you, fuck you, do your makeup at the same time. For a hell of a long time, that when they make these fucking trailers, it should be a federal fucking law that they have a full-length mirror beside every door. So these heterosexuals, when they get ready to leave, they could go, oh no, I ain't wearing this. But no, they don't put mirrors in trailers. They let them come on out and scare the hell out of the rest of us. Okay, ladies, I want to welcome you to the club. Thank you for picking Charlie Brown's Cabaret and Backstreet for a bachelorette party. You did not know me when you come in here, and honey, relax. You look like a deer in fucking headlights sitting there looking at me. I'm not going to fuck you, okay? If anything, I'll improve you. But I want you to just relax and have a good time with us, because honey, you did not know me when you come in here.
But I promise each and every one of you bitches, you ain't gonna fucking forget me when you leave here, okay? And when you get back to the trailer park, or when you go back to work at the Waffle House, you're gonna say, oh my God, we went to Backstreet, you should have seen that fat bitch, Charlie Brown. See, I've done made you laugh more than your boyfriends or fiancés. Well, they fuck you, so they probably made you laugh. But anyway, so party with us, all right? You got?
One.
How many bridesmaids in this bunch? Six. What color did you pick? Mustard.
Puce.
Silver. Oh, that's attractive on an ugly girl with no makeup.
You are so sweet.
Silver. She's got
I should know. Look at me, bitch. My jewelry costs more than the furnishings of your fucking trailer. Now, you don't need to start with me. Your trailer out. I'm sweet. No, I ain't, bitch. Why do you think these people come here to see me? You're northern? Then, honey, I ain't facing you one motherfucking minute now. I've been to New York. I asked what time it was, and this bitch said, do I look like Big Ben, motherfucker? Do you want to know what time it is? By a fucking watch. So, see, I pay you Yankee-ass motherfuckers. Oh, by the way, we're flying in some of your family right now on Air Train, okay?
Man, Air Train, I hate those guys.
Let's put them on the Kennedy Airlines. Maybe they'll get them here. Patsy Cline Airlines? John Denver Airlines. Send a Russian submarine after them. Put them on an American spy plane. Oh, let my people go. Oh, fuck it, I hate this bitch. Let's do an Amish ride by shooting. Okay. Y'all ready to party?
Yeah.
and every one of y'all made it down the interstate tonight to be here. Yesterday was no day to be on the interstate. Look at this group. The short bus has arrived. Where are y'all from?
Atlanta.
What you do, jog in here, bitch?
It's like that 70s show.
It looks like my last supper. You live in Midtown? Where do you live? Southside. Where? Forest Park? That's not Atlanta, honey. No, it's your address is Forest Park, right? That's not Atlanta. It's not Atlanta. He said, it's Forest Park, bitch! Same barber! See? Never, like I told you earlier, never cut your bangs while your hair's wet! See, he cut his right in his eyebrow level. Look where they ended up. As way up his fucking forehead.
Yo, yup, yup, yup.
Yeah, it was a Three Stooges laugh. You want me, don't you, bitch? Is it me you want, or you want my titties? My titties are bigger than yours, aren't they?
Your titties are bigger than
ours. Shut the fuck up. You are the Miss Mouth of this bunch, aren't you? You have got to put your little Yankee ass in all of it, all right? Had 2 minutes of fame, all right? We want to see or hear anything else out of you, I'll watch the fucking History Channel, all right? Damn, how do y'all put up with you? Wouldn't you hate to fuck her if you was a man? My God, that little bitch would be laying there going, getting fucked, going, the one laying next to her, sitting next to her, be laying there going, conversation.
Damn, I'm good.